What the fuck? What the fuck? Stop playing! What the fuck? Stop playing! What the fuck is that?
Trapped in the back. How's everybody doing and how's everybody feeling? Is everybody peace? Is everybody 1980s Schwarzenegger movie? Just shooting shit for no reason. So Sylvester Stallone movie, Van Damme movie, fucking Steven Seagal movie. God damn, the 80s was violent as fuck. Even G.I. Joe cartoons was fucked up. Man, 80s is crazy. Anyway, it's fucking what the fuck Wednesdays. And I can't breathe. God damn, we got nosy people just taking pictures of my house and shit. I don't know what they doing here. Anyway, Gary fucking Moore still got the blues. So I'm assuming Gary Moore is blues. I remember Gary Moore before and I remember enjoying Gary Moore. I think he was a smooth bard type dude. Like he was, you know what I'm saying? He had a smooth vibe, like, if I remember correctly. It was a very long time ago. My camera's all crooked. It's because, you know what it is? My living room's on a hill. So all my furniture's like this, which is good because if I'm eating some shit and I got to get to the bathroom quick, I just slide to the bathroom and drop a deuce. It's fun. I don't know what I'm talking about. Gary Moore still got the blues. Oh, yo. Thank you for the subscriptions, subs. Thank you for, let's get to the 10,000 subs. Thank you for the comments, the shares, the likes, the donation to the GoFundMe. If you're donating, if you're not, fuck it, we're about to fuck with Gary Moore. Gary Moore hasn't donated, and we're still good, me and him. We've been good for a while. Rest in peace, Gary Moore. From what I understand, he has passed away. And for what? I don't know why he passed away. Let me know, and let's talk about his legacy and what he's left behind, right? Anyway, Gary Moore still got the blues. Let's get to it. Enough with the bullshit. I talk too much. Let's go.
Used to be so easy. Found out the hard way, there's a price you have to pay. I found out that love was no friend of mine. I should have known.
Yo, this shit is dope. This shit is really good. I like the strings and shit, the way they came in. And he sang. Now I know why you, when you requested, because this, I forgot my man's name. He always says Gary fucking Moore. Gary fucking Moore. He can't just say Gary Moore. He has to emphasize the fuh and the and the k and the n and the exclamations. And yo, he's really loving this guy. And I get it. You have women issues. I see it now. But he's dope and he got that soul shit, that blues. He's feeling himself. And the music is really good too. I'm not mad at it. I think I'm gonna cry at the end of this, but let's go.
So long ago, but I've still got the blues for you. Used to be so easy. Still got the blues.
In blues, is it supposed to sound kind of dirty? Because the guitar, to me, it sounds a little muddy in comparison to other bands that I've heard. Not in the same genre. I'm not comparing it in that. If I had a blues song, then I'd probably know better, but I haven't heard much blues on this channel, which is a fucked up thing. I haven't heard much blues or jazz, so send me some more blues and jazz suggestions. I get a lot of metal and a lot of odd shit, but I don't get too much blues and jazz suggestions. So my question is blues more muddy and not as sharp? It's more like feeling than rather than technique, is that the word? You feel this. Let's go. This shit is hard. He should have sang that same melody that the melody that the guitar is doing would be great with vocals. If somebody sang the guitar riff with vocals, I think it sounds amazing. What you think? I think that'd have been dope. Like maybe his last 8 bars, if he would have just took the melody of the guitar and put lyrics to it. Add, you know what I'm saying? Am I making sense? Let's go. Is that Gary Moore playing the guitar? I'm asking because I don't remember the first time I listened to him, so I didn't even remember who. I just know it was him singing. If so, you know, where does he rank amongst blues guitarists, I guess? It's dope. I'm enjoying this. I hope he's not in a relationship, because if he is, that person that he's with is not getting no attention, because he's worried about somebody from the past, and maybe he should let that go. Or go find that person and go be with that person and stop whining about the shit, right? Because now he's miserable. The person he's with is not getting real love. Might as well go somewhere else, right? I don't know. Let's go. Gary fucking Moore still got the blues. Now I know what that reminded me. That's why I like that guitar riff. It reminded me of, Any feeling? How's that song go? Any feeling in your heart? And I haven't got a clue. I love you. Who is that? That's Lionel Richie. I can see it in your eyes. Some shit like that. Lionel Richie? I don't know music. I don't remember. The melody sounds like the lyrics to. Yeah, hello, is it me you're looking for? The blind video when the lady makes the shit. You know Lionel Richie. Everybody knows Lionel Richie. He got a face like a horse. This was dope. I have no complaints about it. I'm glad Gary fucking Moore was suggested so much. I appreciate that. Mind you, I just took a link from one of them. Again, I'm taking random. On certain people, because certain people get so many suggestions for this person or band that I'm gonna lose my brain trying to just choose one that'll make everybody happy. So I just grabbed random. So I grabbed Still Got the Blues random, and it was dope. He has women issues. He needs to figure out what the fuck he's gonna do about it. And when I say he, not him, because he's dead, I'm talking about people who listen to this music. Yeah, I'm not getting into relationship shit. I'm not mad at it. For What the Fuck Wednesdays, Gary Moore was dope. I hope you guys appreciated it. I appreciated it. Thank you for your time, your suggestions, your comments, the subs. Let's get to 10,000 subs. The donations, if you donated, the link is below in the description. If not, just come back and keep suggesting. Good things or bad things or fucking whatever the things. And all you haters in the comments, hugs are free. So
come and spread your arms if you really need a hug. Afrocentric living is a big shrug. A life filled with, that's what I love. A lower plateau is what we're above. If you diss us, we won't even think of. We'll nip of the dog and give a big shove. This rhythm really fits like a snug glove. Like a box of positives, it's a plus love. As the trial flies high like a dove.